Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, we'll look at the calculations for weak acids as it'll show up on your MCAT. You can find my entire series along with a practice quiz and cheat sheet by visiting my website, leiaforsci.com/MCAT acid base. Recall that a strong acid is something that will dissociate 100% when placed into solution. For example, HCl placed in water will completely break apart to give you H+ and Cl-. A weak acid, on the other hand, doesn't dissociate completely, but instead you have an equilibrium between the reactants and the products. For example, if we look at acetic acid, which is HCH3CO2, and we place it into water, you have to show this reaction with an equilibrium back and forth arrow, because some of the acetic acid will dissociate to give us H+ and CH3CO2-. But when you have the acetate forming, some of the acetate will attack the H+ and reform acetic acid in solution. So instead of a one-way arrow to show that everything dissociates, we have the two-way arrow to show that there is some equilibrium between the two. Now this is very important for the MCAT because you'll have to do different calculations based on this equilibrium. So think about how you set up the expression for any equilibrium reaction. You have the concentration of products divided by the concentration of reactants. For this reaction, let's first simplify. Acetic acid is a proton, which I'll write as H, bound to an acetate, which we'll call A. It breaks up to give me a proton and then acetate, which is negative, which we'll represent as A-. For the concentration of products, we have H+ and A-. And for the concentration of reactants, we have HA. And so the equilibrium expression for an acid dissociation, if you call that acid HA regardless of the acid, is going to be written as the concentration of H+ A- over HA. If it's aqueous, you'll sometimes see it written as H3O+ instead of H+, but it's the same exact thing, so either one works. Now there's a specific name for this type of dissociation, and that is the KEQ, the equilibrium constant of acid dissociation. So think of KA as the KEQ of A, the acid dissociation constant. You have to both know this equation and understand this equation for the MCAT. What do I mean by understand this equation? The MCAT loves ratios and comparisons. So what does this tell you? Well, the Ka is a good indicator for the strength of an acid, and when we say strong or weak acid in the context of a Ka, we mean a strong acid within the weak acids, or a weak acid within the weak acids, because a proper or true strong acid has a 100% dissociation and no Ka, or a Ka of infinity. If we discount the concentrations of the acid and conjugate base, but instead just look at the H+, you'll notice that Ka is proportional to the H+ concentration. And what this tells you is that if you have a high Ka, that means you're going to have a high H+ concentration. Now recall that pH is equal to negative log the H+ concentration, and that the negative log will flip the relationship, so that if you have a high H+ concentration, you're going to have a low pH. The lower the pH, the stronger the acid, so a high Ka is a strong acid, which means that if we have a low Ka, we'll have proportionally low H+ concentration, which means we're going to get a high pH and therefore a weak acid, or potentially a good base, depending on how high that pH is. Now, if you had to do calculations, for example, to find the H+ concentration or the pH, in Gen Chem, you learned how to set up an ice chart for the reaction, where you started out by writing the reaction, and then you had ice for initial change and equilibrium. And then you wrote your molarity initial, you put zeros for a non-dissociated acid, minus X for the change, plus X, and then after all of that, we have molarity initial minus X, X and X. Now this ice chart is great for Gen Chem, but if you find yourself doing this on the MCAT, you are wasting your time. I'm going to show you a shortcut, but first, let's see why that shortcut works. For a weak acid dissociating, you only expect a very small amount of that acid to break apart. For example, acetic acid has a pKa of 4.74 and a Ka that is equal to 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. Now think back to what that Ka tells you. If Ka is the ratio of H plus A minus over HA, and we have a number on the order of 10 to the minus 5, that means we have a very small number, which comes from having a very low numerator and a very high denominator. When you divide a small number over a big number, you get something on the order of 10 to the minus 5 or smaller. Now, if the acid breaks up to give us H plus and A minus, meaning it's giving off X, and the Ka is such a small number, that tells you that the amount of X coming off is really, really small. If you have an initial molarity that is around 3 powers or more greater than the Ka, so for example, if we start with an initial concentration of 0.1, that's 1 times 10 to the minus 1, 10 to the minus 5 is more than 3 powers away, more than 3 powers smaller, that value of X is negligible. It's like saying I have the number 1 and then I'm subtracting 0.0001. If I work this out, I get an answer of 0.9999. On the MCAT, close enough is good enough, so we want to round, and what does this round to? 1. That means the amount that we subtracted was so tiny it's negligible and it doesn't change it. Now, if we're plugging values into the Ka, then we have the equation as follows. Ka is equal to the H plus concentration of X, the A minus concentration of X, so that's X times X, divided by molarity initial minus X, but we said that X value is negligible. What we're really looking at is X squared over molarity initial. And this is why you don't need an ice chart on the MCAT. Because if you find yourself trying to calculate something like the pH, you're trying to find the H plus concentration at equilibrium, which is X. Simply set up your equation so that Ka is equal to X squared over the molarity initial of your initial acid. Solve for X to get your H plus concentration, and then do negative log of the H plus concentration, estimate your answer, and you'll have your pH. Let's try a quick example. Find the pH of a 0.0009 molar solution of acetic acid, given that the Ka of acetic acid is 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. The first thing you want to recognize is the fact that you're given a Ka tells you that it's a weak acid, and it tells you there will be an equilibrium in solution and not a 100% dissociation. To find the pH, we have to recognize that it equals the negative log of the H plus concentration, so that's the first thing we need to find. But for the weak acid, we have to set up the expression. If Ka is equal to X squared over molarity initial, where X squared is equal to the H plus concentration, we have to isolate X. Multiply both sides by molarity initial, which gives me that molarity initial times Ka is equal to X squared, and then take the square root of both sides. Now let's solve for X. So we know that X is equal to the square root of the molarity initial times the Ka, where the molarity initial is 0.0009, and the Ka is 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. Which is great, but how do you solve this without a calculator? So we'll have to use some of the math tricks which I teach in my math series. The first one we want to do is to simplify this. I'm going to round this 9 to a 10, like that, which gives me 0.001, and I'll round the 1.8 up to a 2. Now I want to combine my scientific notations. If I move the decimal 1, 2, 3 spaces to the right, that means I multiplied by 1,000. I have to divide this one by 1,000 or decrease it by 3 powers, which gives me negative 8. And that means X is equal to the square root of, well, 1, we just drop it out, 2 times 10 to the minus 8. Now this is so much easier to do. We can split this up as 2 times 1 times 10 to the minus 8, and the square root of 2 is a number you should have memorized as 1.4. Taking the square root of 10 to an even power, just divide that power by 2. 10 to the minus 4. And that means X, which is equal to the H plus concentration, is equal to 1.4 times 10 to the minus 4. Just to show you how close we are, when punching the initial numbers into the calculator, I got 1.27 times 10 to the minus 4. How close is 1.4? But we're not done. We now have to do pH is equal to negative log the H plus concentration, which is 1.4 times 10 to the minus 4. Again, we're going to round 1.4 down to 1, and the pH is approximately 4. In fact, punching this number into the calculator, I got a pH that is equal to 3.896. Talk about close. Be sure to join me in the next video where we look at how to do calculations for weak bases. And you can find that, along with the mentioned links, the rest of this series practice quiz and cheat sheet by visiting my website, layerforsci.com/MCATAcidBase. Are you stuck on a specific MCAT topic? I offer private online tutoring where I focus on your needs to strengthen your individual weaknesses. Tutoring details can be found using the link below or by visiting my website, layerforsci.com/MCATTutor. Are you overwhelmed by the sheer volume of information required for the MCAT? Are you worried that lack of a proper study plan and low MCAT score will prevent you from getting into medical school? My new ebook, The MCAT Exam Strategy, a 6-week guide to crushing the MCAT, will help you formulate a concrete study plan by helping you figure out where you stand now, identify your goals, and figure out what it takes to reach them. And it's yours free when you sign up for my email newsletter at MCATExamStrategy.com. By signing up for my email newsletter, you'll also be the first to know when I have new videos, MCAT study guides, cheat sheets, tips, and so much more. The link again, MCATExamStrategy.com.